Welcome back to the second half. Change of jerseys for St Mary's. They're in the blue jerseys, but not too many changes in personnel. Maurice Fitzgerald has gone to midfield. Declan O'Sullivan has gone in full forward for Drummond Pearce's, and probably a good move with the wind in the second half. 6 points to two, remember, St Mary's lead. We continue with the action. Ball driven inside for Declan. He's taking on Stephen Curran, and Stephen Curran hauls him, and it's Paul Mahoney, I beg your pardon, Paul Mahoney pulls him to the ground. That could be a yellow card for Paul Mahoney because, well, both lost their footing, in fairness, I suppose, to Mahoney, and the referees giving him a very, very stern warning indeed. And Declan with a muddy shirt and the muddy togs, but he's not going to worry about it. It's going to be a free from him. Can he put it? Three between him. 6 points to two. Just 30 seconds into the second half. Here he comes. Declan, wind advantage. Makes no mistake. Great score from Declan O'Sullivan. Exactly the score that Drummond Pearce has needed here for the start of the second half. 6 points to three now. They're going to certainly put it up to St Mary's. Make no doubt about that. Rain very much to their advantage now. Paul O'Mahony, as he has gone in full back, marking Declan O'Sullivan. So it's 6 points to three in favour of St Mary's. Can Drummond Pearce's win their first senior South Kerry senior championship match? Here's Darren Corcoran, the St Mary's custodian, lining up to take this kick out. A free for a foul on himself by one of the St Mary's players. I think it was by Stephen Curran, and he could find himself very lucky not to have been booked by it, because he certainly Declan to the ground. Declan won the free in. He pointed the free, and it's St Mary's with Brian Sheehan his possession right here in front of us. Took an awful lot out of that. Yeah, good decision there. Derby SF free to Drummond.
Absolutely, and fantastic defending by the Drummond defenders there. There were five or six or seven players around Brian Sheehan. He could absolutely nothing to the ball. He couldn't even drop it.
Well, Drummond Pearces are sticking to their task. Maurice Fitzgerald has gone back here in the second half. St Mary's have changed their jerseys in the second half. They're wearing a blue set of jerseys. Some of them have the same numbers. Some of them. Well, I'm doing the West Kerry final tomorrow, and if they change their jerseys at halftime, I'll be in serious trouble. It's a good thing that I don't have to look at a programme for these lads anyway. Brian Sheehan has the ball. Brian Sheehan, and in front of him is James Fitzgerald. He's 12 in the first half, but he's 17 in the second half. Back to Brian Sheehan again on the overlap. This is Garrod O'Driscoll, and Garrod O'Driscoll's shot is blocked inside there, and Drummond pierces with Kevin Jackie O'Sullivan. Kevin, Drummond are still in the maroon and white. They're probably maybe a new set of jerseys, but they're the same colour and they're the same number. And here's Brian Sheehan back to Austin Constable, drives it into no man's land, into Timmy Sullivan. And Timmy, about 2.5 minutes gone in the second half. 6-3 to St Mary's. St Mary's with that 4 points lead at halftime. And don't forget, they're going for the four in a row. We had a four in a row team introduced at halftime. I spoke briefly about it before the interval. It was the great Valencia team of 1979. Some great players. Mick O'Connell, Pat O'Connor, Ger Lynch. And of course, Mick O'Connell got a rousing reception here from a nicely packed Waterville. But conditions need a lot to be desired. Drummond pierces into the attack again. Their own half-back line, Kevin Jackie O'Sullivan drives it long, but St Mary's have put a player back there. That's Stephen Curran. Stephen was slightly tugged. He should have won the free. There's a chance here for Fergal Connor if he can get anything out of it. There's a loose man inside. A chance of a goal for Drummond to Declan. What a save. What a brilliant, brilliant save from Darren Corcoran. Came off his line and absolutely buried Declan out of it from nowhere. Buried the ball and buried the kick and kept St Mary's in it. Declan was 1-1. It's a free in, but Derby, that could have been it.
Oh, that's his third great. It was an absolutely exceptional save. Great play by Fergal Connor. He beat two defenders, drew his man, and passed it on to Declan. And Declan really would have fancied Declan to score for there, but it was no fault. It was an absolutely fantastic save by Darren Corcoran.
Well, Darren Corcoran has been called into the St Mary's line out today, of course. Their usual custodian is Seamus Fitzgerald. Seamus is out. I met him actually only 2 days ago in Castlebean, and he has a hand in a sling. Seamus got injured in the semi-final against Renard. Briefly, there's a player down injured, Derby. You saw a lot of the championship this year. I didn't see a whole pile of it. What was your overall opinion on the championship this year?
It was a good competitive championship. You know, it was typical district board championship at this time of the year. There was plenty of heart and plenty of spirit. And I don't think there was any probably Aidan Sullivan's display in the first half in the game, both against Valencia and again against Drummond. And he went half injured, was probably the highlight. And Brian Sheehan, but today Brian, somebody said at halftime he was carrying ankle injury, and he's not the same today.
There's only two between them, 6-4, and Fergal Connor tips over that 14-metre free for his second free of the afternoon, and we are closing up on the second half. Well, I did say in the first half that the elements will pay a lot, will have an awful lot to do with the second half performance. Drummond Pearces are with the elements. They've put Declan O'Sullivan in at full forward. John Curran is still at right corner forward. Fergal O'Connor has gone to the left, and I suppose Derby, a good move in moving Declan in anyway. There was no point having him out around the mid of the field.
Yeah, and this is a fantastic start for Drummond to get 2 points in the first 5 minutes. A great start, and they really are right in this game with a right good chance now.
Well, they're in with a great chance. Their first final ever, and they'll never have a better chance than this one. They're 6-4 to St Mary's, but knowing St Mary's, they're not going for four in a row for nothing, and it'll take a fair good team to beat them. Will that team be Drummond in front of the stand over in the far side? It's going to be a free while tempers flare up a little bit again. And totally unnecessary over on the far side. I can't for the life of me see who's involved there, but there are about, well, I was going to say there's three or four. You could now multiply that by about another three or four. Derby unnecessary for this kind of play here.
Absolutely. I suppose the conditions lean just more to it, but in fairness, there's no sense to carry on at all. So
no.
Very much in the far off side of the field from us. We can't really see who's involved there, but there's no need for it.
Well, I see Donny Corden is out there. He's the peacemaker, and Donny, of course, elder statesman of this Drummond Peace. John Cahill, he'll have to take a little bit of a grip on this derby.
Absolutely, yeah. He will have to issue a yellow card and a red card if fellas don't cop them to run.
He certainly will, because he's leaving an awful lot go. And I mean, the only thing is, you know yourself, to quieten any player is to give him a yellow card.
Absolutely, yeah.
Well, play is continuing on, and it's St Mary's who have it very far away from us, about 70 yards away from us. Is it Ray Keane that's over there? Is Drummond a man? There's a Drummond out of the ball. That's Colm O'Connor, and Colm wins it in, gives it to Kevin O'Sullivan, who finds himself in space. Long ball again for Fergal O'Connor. There was a push on the back there by Mark O'Shea, but he got away with it. And while I don't want to be too critical of the referee, but he was at least 60 yards from that, and certainly that was a free into Drummond Pierce's. John Allen O'Sullivan gives it to Liam Corcoran, plays it into the middle again. Is this Morris? It is. It's Morris Fitzgerald, and there's three players around him, and John Cahill gives him the free there in the middle of the field. Morris Fitzgerald, Jack O'Connor's gone 25 yards into the field to play. He's trying to issue instructions to something there. See from here what
he's trying to tell Declan, I think, to move in and stay inside full forward.
That's it, yes, you're spot on, Derby. That's what he's trying to do, and Declan has gone in there now again. Declan, the birthday boy today, 21 years of age. Congratulations to him today. Will he be the man to lift the Jack Murphy tonight? In the meantime, it's a free out to Drummond Pierce's, and Donny Corden wants to get on with it, and Donny plays it to Aidan O'Connor, and Aidan, wearing 17, plays it outside again to Kevin O'Sullivan. Kevin in his own half back line drives it long inside for Declan. Three players around him. He leave it to John Corden. John Corden gets it ahead of Gary O'Driscoll. John Corden back here now to Declan O'Sullivan in close attendance. Paul O'Mahony gathers it back again to John Corden. Corden to Declan. Declan fancy his chances at the post if he can. Wings around one of them, knocks two of them. Still John Corden. Will he go for the post? He will, but it cannons after, shoots off the left boot of him, and it's still in possession with Drummond, and it's Fergal O'Connor. Fergal has played very, very well today for Drummond Pierce. Will he leave it to Dinis Shine O'Sullivan? In fact, it's Padraig Sheehan who's gone into the attack. Padraig drives along with Mark O'Shea, gathers it inside the number seven, and Mark punches it out the field to another player over there. Is it Mark? It is. No, it's not. It's Brian Sheehan who's over there. And Brian Sheehan, two Drummond players around him. And Brian is fouled there. And it's going to be a free out for St Mary's. One of them was Fergal Connor. Here now is St Mary's. They're trying to get something, fighting very hard for this one. This is Morris. Morris Fitzgerald out around the middle, plays it to the onrushing Liam Corcoran, who pulls in his soccer style but loosely pulls in it, and it's going to be a Drummond man, and the Drummond man is Kieran Maul O'Sullivan. Kieran, of course, a man who was back in 97 on Jack Connor's Scully Connell team that won the All-Ireland. He played, I think, full forward on that occasion, giving his eye to John Corn, and Garrod Driscoll having a great battle all day. Garrod, fresh from winning the county championship with South Kerry, leaves it to Liam Corcoran, who drives it long for Austin Constable. But so far, Donal Sullivan has won this battle. But Constable has won this one. He'll fancy his chances here. Austin Constable has got the first score of the second half for St Mary's. They lead 7-4. Derby, a good score there.
Oh, that's a huge score for St Mary's against a strong wind. Austin won it well and took his chance very well indeed.
Yeah, the team captain leading there by example. Aidan O'Connor in the meantime has come out and having a word here with Jack, and there's a few more players warm up, I think, down here. Are they suffering the injuries? Derby, I think a few Drummond players warming up there.
Yeah, there are a couple of warming up there. They might be giving I'm surprised that Travers and Sean Travers isn't playing.
In the meantime, Aidan O'Sullivan wearing number 26. Well, we wouldn't want to be going by this by the programme. 26 is Liam Sheehan. But that's Aidan O'Sullivan gone in there. Yes, it is. It's Aidan O'Sullivan gone in. Liam Corcoran has gone off the St Mary's team. Morris Fitzgerald gathers the kick out and transfers it to James Fitzgerald. James, after him is Cian Hallisey, giving it a loose one, and Kieran Maul, and a high challenge there by Morris Fitz. The referee says, well done there. Play on advantage, and another high challenge here. And he can't leave that one go. That was by James Fitzgerald again. And Jack is calling the shots down here. He's telling John Travers to get yourself ready. He's going to come into the action. There's no doubt about that. Derby mentioned it because its conditions will suit. He's a big, strong player, is John Travers. We'll continue with the play. Brian Sheehan transfers it on to Colm Connor. Colm, wearing number 8, gives it back to Padraig Sheehan again. Padraig, the team captain. Colm Connor loses possession, loses the ball, and loses his footing, but it's driven inside. who's very lively today. Fergal from an acute angle across the face of the goal, and that's gone to the right and wide. That's a chance going to miss, but I think Derby, you're right, you'll see the introduction of John Travers, I think.
Yeah, Sean has just warmed me up there. He probably will suit the conditions out there. Right, that was a reasonably good chance by Fergal Connor there, and
yeah, 10 minutes gone, 10 minutes in the second half, 7-4. I suppose Derby, well, if you were to say Mary's follow, you wouldn't want it, but a goal would make a terrific game of this one.
Absolutely, and Drum would definitely need a next score now, need it quickly.
They do indeed. Aidan O'Connor has it. Aidan making good inroads. Aidan O'Sullivan coming to meet him, but he leaves it off to John Curran. John to Kevin, Jackie O'Sullivan. Kevin with the left foot, dangerous inside, held inside there by the man who's been sound as a pound inside there all day, and that man is goalkeeper Darren Corcoran. And Darren plays it outside it to Stephen Curran, who had number 3, he now has 25 in his back, and he plays it to Niall Driscoll, who's lost possession, and Drummond are fighting tooth and nail for everything, and it's Cullum Connor who wins it. Cullum back to Kieran Maul. Will Drummond be successful with their first ever South Kerry Championship final? This one has gone away to the gone wide again, and there are chances, Derby, that Drummond will rule.
Absolutely, and that was a very poor kick, in fairness, by Kieran Maul. He never looked up at all, and there was no chance at all of kicking that point from where he tried to kick it from. And they're actually bringing on now young Kevin Leary. He was suffering from an injury there all the week, and he's just also coming in.
Yeah, Kevin Leary has gone into the side. Is it John Curran who's gone off? I think Kevin Jackie O'Sullivan looks to be moving to the right corner of our position. It is. It's John Curran who's gone off, and Kevin O'Leary is in. He's roughly out around the left half hour position. John Allen O'Sullivan is following him. So John Allen is. So that looks to be where he is. A lot of pushing there, and I think the man penalised for it was Morris Fitzgerald. So Morris puts his hands to his head, and he probably acknowledges it. Yes, it is. It was Morris. So Declan O'Sullivan now has this free exactly on the 45-metre line. He'd probably end up about 42 or 41 metres by the time he'd kicked it. And the wind is to his back. He's having a little bit of a chat then, a little bit of banter with Morris Fitzgerald. And of course, they were great buddies this year in winning the South Kerry Championship. And, well, a few little remarks passed between the two of them. Nothing malicious or nothing at all about that. A little bit of a remark by Declan. Morris acknowledges it. Declan with the left. Declan, oh, wide. Bad miss, Derby.
Yeah, that's a big chance miss by Drummond there. A big chance, a great chance by Declan. And Drummond dearly need a next score within the next couple of minutes.
Yeah, they do, because as we mentioned in the first half, Morris Fitzgerald wasn't missing those chances in the first half for St Mary's.
Absolutely not. And he's playing a very influential role now as a holding job out around the middle of the field, as we thought he would do in the second half there.
He is indeed, and I see Declan has gone out around the middle of the field again. I thought they were going to leave him inside. In the meantime, another free in. Garrod O'Driscoll this time, Pina. And this one is a way closer in, and it'll be about 40 metres out. And Derby, he could very easily pop this one now.
Yeah, we'll have to expect him definitely, if Drummond are to go anywhere, Declan has to knock this one over the bar.
Well, I see the Drummond chairman down here in front of me, Jeremiah O'Shea. He's facing and winning the battle against the elements down there, and it is wind and rain here in Waterford. If you've just joined us, the second half is, how long old is it, Derby? It's about 14 minutes old, the second half, yeah. Closing up in 14 minutes. It's 7-4 to St Mary's. This is an important kick from Declan O'Sullivan. Can he put two between him? He can indeed. Well, he missed the last one, which was a bit heuristic on behalf of him, but he'd no problem with that one, Derby. Two between him.
Yeah, it's a very important score. Very important score, and if Trump can get another score, you're going to be in for a mighty last 15 minutes.
Oh, you are indeed. 7-5. Nothing between him. We've said it before. If Dermot Pierce's have any chance, and have a good chance, today is their day. The elements are with them now in the second half. They trail 6-2 at halftime. So far, Austin Constable has been the only man to score for St Mary's in the second half. But Drummond have tagged on 3 points. Kick out again. 3 St Mary's players go for it. The man battling for it over there is the right halfback, Dinis Shine O'Sullivan. He's the team trainer. He plays it back to Kieran Maul. Crossfield ball for Mike Connor over there as well, gathering it in again. It's another Drummond man. It's Cullum O'Connor. Will this be one between them? It will!
Yeah.
Cullum Connor popped up from nowhere, and with the left boot, Derby 7-6.
Yeah, huge score from Cullum Connor, and he's starting to really get into the game there as well, and it was well broken down by Mike Connor to him there, and he took it very well with his left leg, because he's naturally right. That was a fine score.
Well, the whole population of Drummond, I'd say, Derby, would be safe to say, is down the sideline here today in front of us.
Absolutely. It's a huge day and a fantastic achievement for the Drummond club as well. Coming all the way from Division 5 not too many years ago now, to be playing in a South Kerry final, to be within one score now
of
the reigning champions.
And great credit to them. And this year, the course in the championship, they defeated. They had a home win over Waterville in the quarter final, and they had a victory over Skellig Rangers in the semi-final. And they are now 1 point away from the Marys. The Marys in deep trouble, going for 4 in a row. This will ask a lot of the St. Marys team. dominant in South Kerry for the last few years, but by God, if they come out of it today, they'd be well worthy champions. Drummond have pinned them back and pinned them back to the last. Brian Sheehan now has the ball in his own half-back line, and Colm Connor closes in on him and gives it to Ray Kane. Ray Kane is still only 45 yards out from his own goal, but gives Niall Driscoll. I said he gave him a great pass, he did, but Niall Driscoll fluffed it over there in front of the stand. And Keane Hallisey, it's all Drummond Pearces. 7-6, 15 to go. Will they be crowned champions for the first time in their life? Mike Sheehan, the secretary, is down here in front of me. As I said, Jeremiah Shea, the down here in front of me. And nearly everybody from Drummond is down here in front of me. And Aidan O'Connor has it. Aidan O'Connor over in the far side, playing the ref, looking to win a free. Not getting the free, but there's a loose man inside here. But going back there is, I think it was, is it Mark O'Shea that's back there? It is. It looks like Mark, it is. This is Aidan O'Sullivan anyway. Aidan O'Sullivan back to Niall Driscoll. Niall Driscoll in turn to Brian Sheehan. They need Brian Sheehan now more than ever. Brian Sheehan, well, the supporters down here in front of me aren't happy with that decision, but I think, Derby, to be fair, that was a rather high tackle, and it's a free out to the Marys.
Yeah, it was a shoulder from Dennis Shine O'Sullivan, and he caught him maybe in the chest. It's almost impossible now, and the way football is that you can actually give a fair shoulder.
Well, we have about 14 minutes to go. I see Adam Quirk in the meantime has come on, but he's been ordered ashore again because the referee's attention hasn't been brought to that. So St. Mary's trying to ring the changes. The atmosphere is something else over there in front of the stand. And it's Drummond again in their own half-back line, building from the back, and Donie Curran. Well, if any man deserves a South Kerry Championship medal, it's Donie Curran. Declan O'Sullivan gives it back to A. Cullum O'Connor. Donie is going on the overlap. Can he give it to Donie? It's still Aidan O'Connor. O'Connor. Brian Sheehan is with him. Still Cullum O'Connor holding possession and giving it inside to Aidan O'Connor. Yes! Oh, my God, what a kick. All of 50 yards out. The sides are level. 7 to St. Mary's, 7 to Drummond Pearces. Well, now Derby, it's now or never for Drummond.
Absolutely, and that was fantastic play altogether by Colm Connor. He held on to the ball, and I think probably you see a small bit of Jack Connor's influence there on the Drummond team there. He held on to the ball and held on to the ball and didn't give it away. It was absolutely and he gave it to Aidan Connor, and that was a fantastic point from 50 yards. They're in with a mighty chance now.
Mighty chance, 7-all. Brian Sheehan has gone injured, but he's gone into the full forward line. Adam Quirk has come on in the Europa of celebrating with Drummond in that one, or of announcing their celebrations. Anyway, we missed who has gone off, but it's Adam Quirk who's in. Anyway, Declan again, 45 out. Will this be the lead for Drummond? Declan drives it long, but into the hands safely of Darren Corcoran. Corcoran now to Adam Quirk, who has come in. He's gone in the right corner back. I presume he's going to move up to the foul line at some stage. Back to Stephen Curran. They're in trouble. They're in big trouble. 7-all here. Will Drummond do it? Well, Marys are battling hard for everything. They've only 1 point scored in the second half, and it's Drummond again. They fluffed that one. Aidan O'Sullivan made a mess of that one coming out. That's the Aidan from St. Mary's. Fergal Connor fancies his chances, but he didn't realise, Derby, he had a lot more time on the ball there. He could have settled himself and taken a point there.
Yeah, actually the quick free shouldn't have been taken at all. There's a very strong window. There was a great chance for Declan to actually knock that over himself.
Well, worried faces. I'm looking up at the St. Mary's bench, and I see Jordy Sullivan, and I see Seamus Fitzgerald, and I see Powell. And they are very, very worried looking faces. Much happier smiling faces there being the Drummond boys here so far, anyway.
Absolutely, they're in with a great chance now. The next score is going to be absolutely crucial. If Drummond can get the next score, they're there. If Marys can, it'll stem the Drummond onslaught at the moment.
Well, I was asked to mention, as I said earlier on in the show, or earlier on in the game, the two former Drummond men are listing, one in Brisbane, one in New York, Dan Sheehan and Kieran Bobby. Well, lads, you can be feeling very happy. St. Mary's are in trouble here, and Drummond are 7-all with a gale of wind to their back. But scores are things that win them, and a harsh free. What a harsh free on Mark O'Shea there now, Derby. That was a harsh one.
Absolutely, that was a very... I couldn't see really how Mark O'Shea gave away a free there. Very, very harsh free.
Absolutely, yeah.
Mark O'Shea actually has been one of the players that's actually holding Mary's in it at the moment. He's playing very well there in the last 10, 15 minutes. Mark O'Shea has actually been one of the outstanding players by the Mary's there over the last 3 or 4 years.
Declan O'Sullivan, 40 yards out from goal, virtually dead straight in front of the post. I'd nearly put my house in him. This will be, should be, could be the lead for Drummond. Is it? It is! Drummond hit the front! 8-7, and the watch tells us we have got 12 points left. So 8 points to Drummond, 7 to St. Mary's. Derby, it's now or never, we've said it before.
Yeah, and Drummond are playing exceptionally well in the second half. Exceptionally well.
Well, now, Darren Corcoran with the kick out. Is there anything the Marys can do to win? They've lost the grip around the middle of the field.
Yeah, well, it was always a worry here that Marys, this definitely the Marys team, aren't anything as fit as some of the Marys teams that have played over the last couple of years. A lot of their players, and Drummond would hope if they could hang in that their fitness and withstand them today. And definitely fitness will come into in the last 15 minutes now.
Yeah, you're Speaking to Gerdy, of course, doing a few interviews for my good friend here, Christy Reardon, for this video. Speaking during the week to Gerdy O'Sullivan, and that's the one thing that he said will worry us is the fitness of St. Mary's this year. They haven't been as sharp and they haven't been as fit as previous years. But, well, now, experience now. Can Morris swing it for him? Can Brian Sheen swing it for him? Well, with that kind of a kick from Stephen Curran, nobody will swing it for him because he drives it into the hands of Donny Curran. And Declan now is back in his own half-back line, playing a leader's role. Will the Bertie boy lift the Jack Murphy? That's the question. Declan pulled to the ground. Free in his own half-back line, no doubt about it. Dipped the shoulder, won the free. Aidan O'Connor's coming out crossfield here looking for it. Declan spots him. Well, he gives it to Kieran Mowell in the meantime. Kieran gives it to Declan, and now Declan spots Aidan O'Connor. And here is Aidan in front of the dugout, the lower dugout in Waterville, and gives it inside here to Mike Connor. 8-7 to Drummond. And the watch now tells us 10 minutes left. Here's Kevin O'Sullivan. Will this be another one? It's curling dangerously inside there, watching it like hawks inside there. It's held by Cavalieri, chance of a goal, blocked on the left, and the second time Darren Cochran has gone down there, and this could be very well a free out. Well, John Cahill now, I thought he was going to leave play on. You see Mike Connor down here and he's clutching his chest, and it could have been a goal there, definitely. Adam Quirk, Ray Kane is with him. 8-7, time wise we're looking at 9 minutes. 9 minutes left. Adam Quirk in front of the stand. One between them. The Marys need a point to draw level. This one has gone out over the sideline, over on the far side, and it's all going the way of Drummond so far, Derby.
Yeah, and a fantastic tackle again. Actually, Drummond have missed two chances of goals. Darren Corcoran has been absolutely outstanding for St. Mary's in goal.
He has indeed. He's held the minute. The backs of St. Mary's under severe pressure. Mark O'Shea, you mentioned there, Derby. John Allen and the boys.
Yeah, that's right. That same half-back line has played in the three finals that they have won already. Mark O'Shea, Paul O'Mahony, and John Allen.
Absolutely. Well, they're under pressure today. They need one. There's a bit of a holding on both sides between Brian Sheehan there and oh, lovely chipped up off the ground in this wet condition by Brian Sheehan. He's got inside Aidan Sullivan, and then now's a chance for St. Mary's. Can they draw level? Sheehan drawing it inside for Garrod O'Driscoll. O'Driscoll loses possession. They'll need that to give away a free. John Cahill is very close to it. It's a Drummond man coming out with the ball. It's Kevin O'Sullivan, I think. Anyway, this is Dinis Shine O'Sullivan and Austin Constable trying to close in on him. Oh, my word. A high one from Austin, but knowing Austin, and fair play to Dinis Shine O'Sullivan, he pulls himself off the ground. It was a high one, Derby, but it was an awkward one, really.
Absolutely, there in the conditions. I think, in fairness there was absolutely two or three frees. There was a free out, first of all, to Drummond, and there was a free into Mary's afterwards.
Yeah, and but in fairness... yeah, go on, continue. Sorry, Derby.
Yeah, it was a very high tackle, but in fairness, there was nothing malicious about it. And again, the great heart of player, Dinis Shine, he got up straight away and got on with it.
He did indeed. Austin just caught him high. And in the meantime, John Travers is into the action, and Aidan O'Connor has done his part. And he gets a well-deserved clap in the back there from all the substitutes down here in front of us. Time-wise now, Derby is important. 7 minutes, seven to go, and it is 8-7. Drummond winning by a point. First time in the South Kerry final. Will they lift the Jack Murphy? The Marys, warm favourites going into this one, are in trouble. And it is Liam Cochran. Or it's not, it's James Fitz, I beg your pardon. Liam Cochran has gone off. This is James Fitz getting the 1-2 for Morris Fitzgerald. Was that a free? Well, no, play on. Here's Dinis Shine. Dinis gone inside the 45-metre line. Dinis has with him Kieran Mowell O'Sullivan. A high one, Kieran Mowell wins it. Still possession with Drummond. Still Kieran plays it outside to Mike O'Connor. Mike O'Connor, Morris Fitz trying to close down him. Gives it inside now to Kevin O'Sullivan. Kevin fluffed it. Mike T. O'Connor wins it for the Marys. Mike T. back to Ray Kane. Ray Kane and Padraig Sheehan. Still Ray Kane. Padraig Sheehan swinging off him. He wins the free. Morris Fitzgerald takes it quickly and gives it into O'Connor. They're still in back in their own half back line. Our Snare Marys are trying to come out. Will he be penalised for holding on to it? He will. Well, I don't know. Hard way to call that one, Derby, but anyway, it's a free hit.
Yeah,
it's
very hard to release the ball. In fairness to him there, he was pretty unlucky. But again, you'd have to say it was fantastic marking by the Drummond defence.
Yeah, it was indeed. Six, I think. Yeah, about 6 minutes to go. 8-7. I suppose, Derby, you'd feel, with the way the conditions are, if Drummond get one more point, I'd say they're home and dry.
Yeah, it's very hard to see Mary's coming down and kicking anything more than that. But
it is in these conditions anyway, especially.
It's very hard to score against this wind.
Well, they've only won in the second half. That was Austin Constable, Padraig Sheehan. Padraig Sheehan gives it to John Travers, but the less said about that one, the better. That's gone well to the gone to the right and wide. But I suppose now, all these chances, Derby, we've always said it's an old cliche, those kicks are probably as good as points.
Absolutely, and it's a ball gone out of the play anyway, and Marys have to start all over again, and the wind is very, very strong.
Jack O'Connor checks his watch down here in front of us. Well, you know, Jack, you know, Derby is saying, get it all mixed up. Jack, you know Jack is good as anyone, but if It'll be a remarkable year for him anyway.
Absolutely, himself and Declan O'Sullivan have an amazing, it'll be the fairy tale finishing really.
It certainly will. An All-Ireland Sam Maguire County Championship with South Kerry and about to collect the Jack Murphy in the South Kerry Challenger. That's a fairy tale if there was ever one. Now, here is Stephen Curran. Don't rule the Marys out of it yet. I keep saying that because the experience will stand to them and the last couple of years will stand to them with it. I'll tell you, Kieran Mowell has put in a crunching tackle there and they've pinned him. Morris Fitzgerald, four of them around him, five of them around him. And Stevens has lost possession and it's down there and the Drummond are fighting tooth and nail hard for this one. This is going to be a free in. There's a Drummond player down and Morris is standing over him. He's not the man that put him to the ground at all. But Drummond will fancy this one, Derby, from this angle.
Yeah, would it, having said that, in fairness, Gary, that this is a very, very difficult kick. Very difficult kick. As you said before, I think even if the ball goes wide, it'll be as good as a score anyway. Yeah. Anything but to leave the ball in play, I think, would be probably what Jack would be probably saying to Declan.
It's Declan who has it.
He's gone down the sideline to him now. And just to kill the ball, I would say that's what he'll be saying to him at this stage.
I would think so, yeah. He's just in his about 30 yards and he's... Well, behind him is the scoreboard, so that'll tell you where he is. Now, the people go quite down here in the line. This is an important kick. 8-7 to Drummond. It's curling beautifully inside, but it's dropped inside on the goal line and held inside there. And there's a real, real... I don't know how I describe it, but anyway, Darren Cochran has it and he's come out of it. Thomas Curran, in the meantime, is warming up. John Allen, the watch now tells us 5 to go. 5 minutes, 8-7. What a cracking South Kerry Championship. And a credit to every one of those there, because the conditions are absolutely horrendous here in Waterford. In the meantime, there's an off the ball going on in the middle of the field again, and there's a real hell banger between Morris Fitzgerald and between it's John Travers, and no need of it whatsoever. Derby, things have gone out of control.
Oh, absolutely crazy stuff altogether. This is absolutely crazy. And in fairness to Morris Fitzgerald, I think he probably must have been provoked there to get involved there. There's no doubt about that. It was, I actually didn't see the beginning of it, but
I didn't see the beginning of it either, but I saw enough of it and I certainly did not like what I saw. It was hammer and tongs between the two of them. Peace has been restored. Now, if right is right, Derby, I know we're in finals and we're in close, but if right is right, that's two red cards.
Oh, absolutely. There's fist flying and there definitely was fist flying, but it would have to be two red cards.
Have to be. No, so we'll see what John Cahill is going to do here. He may take the easy option and give two yellows, but if right is right, they are two reds. So we're going to see what will happen. He has John Travers around him. He, of course, been just introduced. In the meantime, Eugene Dinahy has been commanded in the linesman. Order has been restored, thankfully. Everybody is up and about all right. So the three of them are crouched. This is a lovely picture. The ref is crouched, Morris is crouched, and John Travers is crouched. Now, Travers is up. He's taking his number. And what is the decision going to be by John Cahill? Let's have a look. Two yellows. Now, I suppose, to be fairness and the conditions, but if right to right and rules to rule, Derby, that shouldn't have been yellow, that should have been red.
Absolutely, there was probably, but in fairness again, it was probably taking conditions and the way things are going here.
I suppose.
Took the easy option.
Well, that's fair. And the time, 2.5 minutes, and the Drummond people are looking up at me here. About 3 minutes to go, lads. That's what you've left. You're up. Declan O'Sullivan in the meantime is being pulled to the ground, and this free is as good as anything. He's still about 60 out from goal, but the pressure is off the back. Declan, Derby, I spoke to him during the week, for a man that carried an injury, by God, he's had some game today.
Yeah, he has been very influential. Again, he's a fantastic stadium influence. He's bringing other players into play and doing all the right things at vital stages there. And Drummond have played, they're much, much the better team in the second half.
They are indeed, yeah, no doubt about it. 8-7. This is about 60 yards out from goal. Well, maybe a little bit in, but we'll call it 55 in here. And it's 8-7, and the wind is to his back. And here he goes, and he drives it long. And that's it! Declan O'Sullivan lifts on this, the photographers. The flashes go off over on the far side. Declan raised his fist to the crowd. Derby, that's the crowning point, I think.
Oh, absolutely. It's very hard to see Mary's coming back from that. Fantastic score. That was well over 60 yards out. He's been absolutely fantastic, in fairness, in the second half.
9-7 to Drummond. Well, a lot of people, their own had great faith in him. A lot of South Kerry thought it would be the Mary's. Padraig Sheehan drives it. 1.5 minutes, maybe two. In the meantime, play is carried on and it is with possession with John Travers. John gives it inside to Padraig Sheehan. He looks to be favourite now ahead of Austin Constable to lift the Jack Murphy. Here's Declan O'Sullivan again. Three Mary's players around him. Gives it back to Fergal O'Connor, who's had a great game. He to Kian Hallisey. He to Kieran Mowell O'Sullivan. He to Aidan O'Sullivan. It's all Drummond. They're holding possession. This is... Well, it's been a fantastic display by them over the top to Dinnishine O'Sullivan, and this is all Drummond 9-7, about a minute and a half to go. They're holding possession. Possession is as good as the score to them. They're trying to make inroads now. They have possession again. Is this going to be another one from Colm Connor? It's not. It's gone across the face of the goal. Nearly all of Drummond is nearly inside around midfield here, Derby.
Absolutely, but that was very good play again by Drummond. They held onto the ball and held onto the ball, and in fairness there, they're not giving the ball away cheaply at all. It's a superb play.
Well, Gerdy O'Sullivan has come down amongst the Drummond support, and he's encouraging, but I think the time is up, and I think Gerdy knows it. Looks to be a what a catch from Kieran Maul O'Sullivan from Drummond again, back to Padraig Shine. They'll be hard to pick a man of the match for this one. Will Declan be involved? For me, Fergal Connor has had a great game. This is driven long by Declan again, and it's held play inside. We'll have a look at the watch. We are on 30 minutes. We are heading for injury time. There won't be a whole lot more. It's 9-7 to Drummond Pearses. A historic day for them. Well, years ago the great Sean Hardcourt was instrumental, not only in South Kerry but in Kerry. Got relegated from Division 1 this year, but they won't be too worried about that. They're about to be crowned champions of South Kerry for the year 2004. The four in a row won't be achieved, I don't think, now by St Mary's, but in the meantime, would St Mary's ever get a goal? You'd never know. Here's Mark Shea. Mark Shea into the middle, and it's Brian Sheehan who's out there now. Brian swinging off 3, 4, 5 players looking for a free and winning the free. Can St Mary's come out of it? That's the question. We'll put it to Derby in a minute. We can't take our eye off it because the Marys are in possession again, and it's another crunching tackle put in there. Player going down with mud in the jersey and everything. It's hard to see who has possession, but it's Drummond that have it, and Declan O'Sullivan is the man back in his own square, selling dummy number one, giving it out to Johnny Cudden, and Johnny Cudden is trying to lift the siege back there. John Cahill, the referee, is looking. It's a free out to Drummond Pearses. Time is almost up, Derby. I'd say they'll be champions now.
It looks very like, and that was a fantastic win by Aidan Shine O'Sullivan there at cornerback. Superb. And it's a fantastic achievement as well for Donny. Donny Cudden playing fullback there for him today, and his son playing above corner forward.
It is indeed remarkable, and as I said it before, if any man deserves it, Donny Cudden deserves it for the way he's done tremendously well with Drummond down through the years. Little bit of 50 cuffs around the edge of the square again, but it's 1-1. It's Kevin O'Sullivan. He's a loose man inside. He picks out the loose man. He could bury it here. Oh, my word, it's gone to the left and white. It was Fergal O'Connor, but it doesn't matter, Derby. 9-7. John Cahill, I think, looks at his watch in the meantime. A little bargy-bargy down here. I think Declan, well, no, Declan hasn't been floored. There's a Drummond Pearses man being floored. He'd probably be well off to blow this one up. He has! It's over! Drummond Pearses are the 2004 South Kerry champions on the scoreline of 9-7. Derby, a full merited win for Drummond.
Oh, a fantastic second half performance altogether. Absolutely, they played with spirit and heart and determination, and really a huge win. And they were always, if it came down to a battle, Drummond were always going to win it today, and it showed. It a fantastic result also for Drummond.
What would you say, Drummond, or Derby, would you say that it was a low par or below par performance by St Mary's today? I mean, I suppose, to be famous, the word we must use is hunger. Drummond were away hungrier.
Well, that was what we were wondering. Would hunger actually beat the experience and physical strength of St Mary's? And it did. It proved it today that hunger did beat him.
Well, I'm talking to Declan O'Sullivan, an ecstatic Declan O'Sullivan. Drummond Pearses collect their first ever South Kerry Championship. Declan, your immediate thoughts?
Can't believe it, with you. Absolutely can't believe it, I suppose. Coming up in Drummond under eight structures. We always aim for this, and we could never seem to get past the first, second round. I became a bit of a curse in all every year we had to win it. I can't believe we finally done it. You can see from the reaction around here, it's absolutely fantastic, and I could never describe what especially the older members of the club can feel it today.
Just to wait, you won an All-Ireland National League and everything, Declan. This is equivalent, really, to those, isn't it, in this situation now?
Yeah, it is. I mean, it's way more, I suppose, emotional as well. You know, these are fellas you grew up with. These are fellas that have been teaching you how to play football since you're under 10, 12, all the way up. And really, like, these are the fellas that you're going to finish off playing your career with as well. And this is what it's all about.
Declan, he came out in the second half and he absolutely dominated the second half. In fairness, St Mary's weren't in it.
Well, I mean, I think, you know, the lads have put in tremendous effort the last 2 or 3 months. I've been going up to Killarney once a week there, and it's a big effort, and the fitness show there. I think we dominated the game. And, you know, in fairness to the Marys, they've been great champions, but I think we were a small bit hungrier today, and I think it showed, really.
Declan, you've a great club, you've great men in charge, great men behind the line. This is a dream come true. And when you look back at the men down through the years who formed the club and everything, it's unbelievable, really.
Absolutely. That's where the club's come a long way from when Sean Hard was going around an event. Look, come playing football for Drummond Pearses, and they were going to Waffle, and they were going here, there and everywhere. And we're delighted we have a club here that's able to put it up to the best in South Kerry. I don't think that anyone will be leaving from Waffle from now on.
No, I'm just after being told you were man of the match. That doesn't mean much to you, I know. You went into the match injured, Declan. How's the injury?
It's a lot better now, is it? A lot better. Well, I mean, I've been good physio all the last couple of weeks from your Hall injury. In fairness, he put in the time and effort. And I think he just held up well there today.
Well, Declan, listen to me. Congratulations. It's a wonderful occasion. It's a great day. This is what the GA is all about. See you on the moorings Monday night.
Absolutely, with you.
Selector, Padraig, an absolutely unbelievable day. We're standing here in the middle of muck and gutter, but listen to me, it's some day for Drummond.
No doubt about it. Like, this is the day we've been waiting for a long, long time. Like, at long last, our luck came. You know, with the Declan, touch luck, Declan was back and for him, like, and he gave a fine display, lads. You know, it meant everything, just like, you know, all the lads played with their hat out. We went to Legion pitch, as I told Christy the other night, and for a reason, and we hopefully, and today we have the result.
Well, I'm glad to say that the Legion was a big help to my own club, but listen, not along Declan, but all the players, the second half, they absolutely left their hats in the field.
Oh, no doubt about it, there's no doubt about it, they surely did. They, you know, they really tried, like, you know, they defended right from the word goal, like.
And the players were in great shape, they were very fit. I know that Jack had a big lot to do with it.
Oh, there's no doubt about it. I said to Christian the other night when I was talking to him before, like, Jack has it up here, like, and, you know, when we got him back with us, it meant everything to us, like.
Did you ever think in your wildest dreams that you win the A South Kerry Championship?
I know we dreamt of the course, like, but it wasn't happening for us, like, but at long last it did.
Listen to me, well done, and enjoy the Jack Murphy Cup. Well done. Mas O'Connor, John Travers, listen, lads, well done, congratulations. A wonderful day, a great win for you. What does it mean to you, Mas?
Oh, jeez, it's unreal. We've been training all year now for this, and finally came through in the end.
What were the instructions going out in the second half when you were trailing, Mas?
Keep battling away no matter what, and not until the final whistle was blown, and we did it and we pulled away in the end, 2 points.
John, listen to me, you have a swollen idea, but I know that won't mean much to you. They've all passed and passed a bit. A great win altogether. What were you told at half time?
Well, at half time, to keep it going. When we thought things were gone from us, just keep going, keep battling, run our legs till we could run no more, to a standstill.
Was that fear at the end there that they might break away and get that goal when you were 3 points up? What were you feeling, John?
3 points is a dangerous lead. I thought when they came down there for one back, and it was a wet day like today, a ball could go anywhere. Into the back of the net or anything.
Listen, lads, what does this mean to the parish of Drummond?
It means the world. We're a long time waiting. I'm 9 years now. First time we ever won it. So,
John, what age are you now?
I'm 22.
22. What does this mean now? Sum up, what does this mean to the parish of Drummond?
It's unbelievable. It's the best thing that could happen to parish for this year anyway.
Well, well done. Go away and enjoy the celebrations, lads.
But what am I doing? Go Gargis then Gordon or son on Clear Brass for tool being enough. I guess Kogargis fresh in the August weakest John Carl, August Aaron or son on Ray Torica Yenche. Right, lads, ladies and gentlemen, today is a historic day, I suppose, in the annals of South Kerry football, where we had a club to one winning today for the very, very first time, Drummond Pierces. This is the year for Drummond, I suppose, with Jack O'Connor and Declan Sullivan winning the All-Ireland for Kerry, and also they were involved with the South Kerry team that won the county championship. So a great year. A great year for the Drummond club, and I think it's culminated in today's victory. Today was a very, very bad day, and I suppose we were lucky all along. We got good days for all our games during this campaign. But anyway, our luck ran out. Today was bad, but anyway, the game was played and everything went off right. A few people I would just like to thank to the Waterford Club for the presentation of their grounds. Everything was in order, and that's very, very important for the day of the South Kerry final. Thank you as well to all the people who officiated, all the stewards, all the people around there that did, the referee and his team of umpires and linesmen. Thank you very much for coming out on a very, very bad day. Thanks to the people who came out. Great crowd here again today, and I think that was indicative of the whole championship this year. We got great crowds, and I suppose it followed on maybe from the All-Ireland of South Kerry's achievements in winning the county final. Look, I won't detain you very long, but I'd say I would just like to mention one person before I go away here today. This man, I suppose he's put his life into Drummond, and you all know who this man is. He wasn't wearing a jersey today, but he didn't need to wear a jersey. Jeremiah, this championship is as much for you as for anybody else. Well done. It's a long road, I suppose. There's no turning. Jeremiah's a long time on the road. I served at Bourne and Oak, and I think if any man deserves to be chairman when Drummond won their first championship, that's Jeremiah. There's a number of other people there, but Jeremiah was a man that was always to the forefront. Right, so beside me here is Paddick Sheehan. Paddick, I won't detain you much longer. And I have great pleasure in presenting the Jack Murphy Trophy to Paddick Sheehan, the captain of the first winning Drummond team. Paddick. Few words now from Paddick.
Tainus or my current short glacker, referring to I'm piercing the drummer. This is an unbelievable day for the club. We've put in so much effort since September. We've been going up to Killarney every Wednesday night and training every Friday and Sunday. We just deserve this because we put in so much effort and this day has definitely been a long time coming because we won everything underage, under 12 up to minors. And then, of course, we had Jack O'Connor. He came in to help us. He had an unbelievable year there with Kerry. And I'd also like to thank Dennis Shine, our trainer. He's playing with us as well, and it's been tough going to play and to manage the team as well. And I'd also like to thank selectors, Padraig Connell, Frank Sugar. There's so many people in the club. Of course, you mentioned there Jeremiah O'Shea. He is the club, lads. And a few more like Mike Sheehan, Mary Sheehan, fucking everyone there, lads. All the underage selectors like Donny Corn, Martin Connor, Jimmy Connell, lads. There's so many people that deserve all this, lads. And I'd also like to thank the players for putting in the effort, lads. Finally into the Marys. Look, three in a row. You're a great team. You set the standard in South Kerry. And I'm sure you won't regard just winning this one, lads. So, three cheers for the Marys. Hip hip. Hooray. Hip hip. Hooray. Hip hip, hooray. That's it, lads.
The Man of the Match Award today. The Man of the Match Award today is being presented again by the Fogarty family, Padraig and Sheelan, in memory of their son Damien, and the adjudicators today were Darby Clifford from Waterville, Pat McCrohan from Renard, and John O'Shea from Filemore. And the man chosen as their man of the match for this year's South Kerry final is Declan O'Sullivan of Drummond Pierces. Happy birthday.
Well, now I'm talking to Jack O'Connor. Jack, listen to me. This is a special day for you. Irrespective of all you won this year, this is special.
It's a special day for the Drummond Club. I mean, you wouldn't think that this was going to happen 20 years ago when the club was only reformed again in 76. And I think all the credit basically goes to this man here. He is the Drummond Pierces Club. In the dark days, he kept things going. When numbers were slack and results were going against us, he just kept the spirit of the club going. So it's a fairy tale, Weeshie. You know, this is a real dream for everyone in Drummond.
And Jack, it wasn't a lucky win. It was a highly, richly deserved win because you simply outplayed St. Mary's in the second half. It was as simple as that.
Well, the desire was there, Weeshie. The question was, were Drummond going to have the desire to win the first one or St. Mary's to win the fourth one? So maybe at the end of the day, the desire won out. I think our fellas were prepared to put their bodies in the line. The tackling there in the second half was something to behold. It was unbelievable. And fair play to the Marys. They didn't throw in the towel. They played a good solid game. And it's hard on them as well. I mean, it would have been nice for them to win the 4 in a row, but I don't think they'll be good just this one, Weeshie.
No, they wouldn't, I don't think. And nobody will, Jack. Jack, this is the basis of the GA down here in a smart club like Drummond. This is what it's all about. Explain it to me. What is it about?
Well, I mean, look, there was a special spice, I suppose, in the South Kerry Championship this year, seeing as Kerry had won the All-Ireland and South Kerry had won the County Championship. So this was going to be special this year. So, I mean, for us to win it and for Declan, to be captain of the Kerry team next year is a real dream for a small club like ours.
A club with a great tradition, Jack. You've grown up yourself. What memories have you of the men when you were a small boy, the men in charge of the club and the men behind the club? What are your memories now? It's only right and proper to remember those people.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, there's people like Sean Haddon-Cotton and John O'Sullivan, each of to John the Gutch, those fellas. They're gone to their eternal rest now, but since I've been with the club, John O'Meara really has been the driver. And it's a fantastic day for him. As I said earlier, the club wouldn't be there without him, no question about it, would she?
Would your late mother have enjoyed this win, Jack?
She would. She would.
Why, yeah?
She would, and I tell you something, she got a ring for me there in the last 10 minutes when I was getting a bit dodgy. I was on the telephone to her, but I'm sure she would wish she was praying for us in heaven.
Listen, Jack, we're not going to talk about Kerry or anything. You're after being involved with Drummond. You're after being involved with Kerry and all their victories. You're after coming from the top in Croke Park down to the muck and gutter and got near the Waterville. I tell you, it was great to be watching you. It was great to be here. This is what the G is all about. Jack Connor, thanks for the memories.
Thanks, Rishi.
Dermot, congratulations. Listen to me. You're a happy man, and I tell you, no man deserves this more than yourself. Well, your thoughts at the moment?
Well, I suppose it's my thoughts. I'm overjoyed with this, and it's a great occasion for the Drummond Club, without a doubt. When you've seen an awful lot of people, you had the Dermot Davies, the David Moriarty, who were all great men that went before them, and several more, I'm just naming two there. Jack O'Connor himself, a great club man, and that elusive medal passed. A pity, but like the one thing I will say is I would like to thank our team management and especially Jack again to come on board there. You know, Jack could be doing something else with his time, but after winning the All Ireland, he gave us his time to South Kerry to Drummond Pearses, and that just tells you how steeped in football he is. As you said there, a question about his late mother. Like, his late mother was a great friend of mine as well. You know, I often met her there in Nini Tavern when Jack owned the shop, and you know, she was always John, she called him, you know, and she had pride in him. And like, you know, he has pride in football and pride in the jersey, and I'm delighted, we'll say, to we win it this year, and I'm delighted. Of course, Declan. If you like, it's very hysteric today for Declan. Declan is 21 years old. Today is his birthday. We're after collecting now the Jack Murphy. He'll be captain of Kerry, and he's going along to Killarney tonight to collect his All-Ireland medal. So that is something, you know.
Dermot, while it's probably one of the worst days that God has sent us this year or last year, the year after, I suppose for you the sun is shining, and it's like at the end of the middle of summer, is it?
Well, we won't worry about that now. It's history now, and that's it. Like, we have the Jack Murphy, which we are looking for to bring to the Valley with an awful long time. As Jack said, the great Sean Harcourt, that farmed out club, and John O'Sullivan, the Winchewate, they were all great men. They gave their time to Drummond and to the GA throughout their life, and many, many more. And Mike Shea and all them, you know, your Michael Sheehan and Mary, of course, Mike and Mary, they're the mother and father of Padre, and like they're one of the, like, Mike is the secretary of the club, and Mary is the PRO, and like any job, like for us, be a cup of tea or scones, Mary have them already, and like Mike went out there last week with me, and I must say this much, is since I became chair of the club, I think he's a tremendous secretary. He leaves no stone unturned, he does an amount of work, and I'm very grateful to all my officers, our fields committee, and everyone involved with Drummond, and also, of course, the South Kerry board. But I must say one thing, we like playing St. Mary's, like we play them at underage level and things like that. And the one thing I will say about them, like, they don't do anything. They try to go out to beat you, but when the game is over, it's over. And that's the way it should be.
And Dermot, just on the game itself, the second half, it was a 15-man effort, really. While Declan O'Sullivan is after being awarded the man of the match, and rightly so, kicking his 5 superb points off a freeze. But really, it was a wonderful all-round display. I mean, each player went out there today and they left their hat and their gut in the field.
Well, for that was a corner back and a corner forward. You were quite correct there. From 1 to 15, I think we'd proved it out there today. We had players maybe that they thought there was a few question marks about them and things like that. But if you look, our players that have came through Colashton and Skellig and Scully O'Connell, the majority of them, and as I think Declan said there to you, or was it Padraig getting accepting the trophy there, we won every stage underage level, and would you believe it, we beat St. Mary's and a few of them titles at underage level, so I think how they have come.
Well, David O'Shea, listen to me, you are a man that the GAA is built on. You're the rock, you're the grassroots, as Jack O'Connor said there, and I'll reiterate what he said, no man deserves this day more than you. And I tell you the truth, you're a credited association. I just say, like, to thank everybody. Thanks for all you've done.
Yeah, I would say, yes, maybe I deserve it, but I don't know. I think the people of Drummond deserve it. That's where I always go to try to achieve something for Drummond. I don't worry about myself. It's for Drummond. Drummond badly wanted this, without a doubt. Our young players and our older players wanted it. You have Donny Cotton there today, 42 years playing fullback, and his son playing, and another son came on. That's what the GA is all about.
Dermot, you're a credit association, boy. Well done, and enjoy the Jack Murphy Cup, because he was a great man himself, Jack Murphy. Yeah, well done, Dermot.
Thanks,
Jordi O'Sullivan, trainer, St. Mary's team. Meant really, but I suppose in the second half they were better than you.
Way better, they were more hungry than us, you know. And look, when you lose the final, it's always disappointing, but you know, we won progression at all because they were more findability than us, and they deserved it and they were way more hungry. Simply.
Jordi Sumfella said one time that hunger is a great sauce, and there's no doubt at all about it. They were all over you in the second half and you just couldn't get going because you looked a little bit tired and a little bit, I suppose, going for four isn't easy.
Well, you know, as I said to Christy there during the week with an interview, about 565 training sessions last Tuesday night, and we're training from January to December for the last 4 years, and these guys inside the medical system don't, you know, the effort they put in was serious for the last couple of years. But we had our rewards. And, you know, we've got to take the good times with the bad times.
But I've no doubt, I was talking to some of the Drummond people, Jordi. They said, by virtue of the fact, not alone did they win it, but to beat St Mary's in the final. It's like winning in All-Ireland. It's like winning in All-Ireland and beating Kerry in the final. So that's a tribute to you, Jordi.
Same thing. I said exactly the same thing. Just like if we want to win the All-Ireland, you'll beat Kerry, don't you? And if we want to win the Stokely Championship, you'll beat the Mayors.
Jordi, I know very well you'd like to say Drummond have won their first ever South Kerry title. You were going for your 25th. I no doubt you want to sum up their display today, Jordi, and sum up the Drummond club for me.
It is a small club and they have progressed all along down through the years, you know, and they have been fantastic work done there. And, you know, and it showed there today. They were, you know, they're out there in the middle of Drummond and nobody sees them what goes on there, but that does tremendous. And great club spirit is there, which you have to have it from the old down to the young. And it's a great credit that they could turn up here today and put in a performance like that. And I'm delighted for I was a bit disappointed, of course, after the final first. But you know, when it's all died out, I'm delighted for them, really. We had our good days. And
finally, Jordi, listen to me. We're down here in the conditions. This is what the GA is all about, isn't it? This is the heartbeat of the GA. This is where Kerry wins their All-Irelands, down here, isn't it?
Certainly is, yeah. And you're going to West Kerry now tomorrow, and it's the same thing. And you go up to Stevens' Day above the North Kerry. So it's the same thing. That's where the footballers are born and bred inside in the days like today.
Listen, great man, keep up the good work. No. And I've no doubt St Mary's will be back, and they'll be back for their 25th whenever it'll be. Well done, Jordi.
Thanks very much, Regan. Thanks very much for
talking to two Drummond ladies, Mary Sheehan and Suzanne O'Leary. Suzanne, listen to me. Wonderful day for Drummond. Listen, how happy are you?
Absolutely, couldn't be happier. It's coming with years. We just so deserve this. It's been a great year. We're delighted for them. They're brilliant.
What did you think of the game? Were you on tender hooks for the whole game?
Absolutely. Look at it really at times. It was unreal. Really, we've deserved this. It's for the whole club. They're just wonderful.
What was your whole memory now of the day?
Oh, it was just, I don't know, it was just coming. I knew it was going to happen today. Today was their day.
You knew it was going to happen. Mary, that was a lovely way to turn over to you. Come here. What did today mean to you? What does it mean to the parish? And tell us what you feel at the moment.
Oh, I'm just so happy. We just can't believe it. Was worked from underage up, and it just means everything. And Padraig, I suppose, is my son. We were on tinder hooks all week, so it was fantastic.
Yeah, was he very nervous all week?
No, we didn't even talk about it in that line.
What do you think things are going to be like in Drummond for the next, I won't say the next week, I'm going to say until the next month, Mary?
It'll be the best Christmas ever. No, it'll be fantastic. It really will, yeah.
Well, listen, ladies, it was lovely to see you enjoying it, and it was lovely to see the first title going to Drummond. Go away now and enjoy it, and we'll see you for Terrace Talk next Monday night. Yeah. Is it okay? Now I'm talking to Gary O'Sullivan. Gary's at the other side of the mic today because I'm talking to him. Gary, you were doing commentary for Radio Kerry there. You sum up the game now. First of all, I suppose, Gary, Drummond to win is really a wonderful occasion, historic occasion, and great for a small rural club.
It is absolutely brilliant, Weezy, for not taking nothing from St Mary's, and I have great friends in the Mary's camping, but I'd say they'd be the first to acknowledge it. It is great from a small club. I'm from a small club myself, and they beat my own crowd in the semi-final, a fully deserved win by them. It is great for Drummond. I spoke to Jack there, and you know, it has been a fairy tale year. He came in, he said he's not taking for it today, but you know, he came in at the deep end, but this is a great year for Declan O'Sullivan, 21 years of age today, and this crowns it all. Sam Maguire and South Kerry County Championship, and now the South Kerry Championship.
And Gary, in actual fact, looking at the game and analysing it, St Mary's never looked like winning the game.
No, they didn't, Rishi. I was looking through, and you'll see the end of this video now, speaking to Jordi O'Sullivan during the week, and the one thing he said that worried him this year was their level of fitness. He said that they weren't as fit as the Mary's team as they were in previous years. Probably, you know, a lot of players away and that couldn't make training and whatever. But the one word, I suppose, that I'd use today was hunger for you're certainly the hungrier team. And I suppose you would be, Wishy. I mean, if you're, you know, it's your first time ever in the final, and you've never won one, so you're bound to be the hungrier team. And by God, they fought tooth and had, you know, tooth and everything.
And while Declan O'Sullivan was awarded man of the match, and rightly so, looking at the game, it was a 15-man effort. And what has personified Jack O'Connor's training of all teams this year is his ability to get the best out of every single player. That is something that he can do.
Absolutely, spot on in that, yeah. You have the likes there, you know, from Timmy Sullivan out in the goal. Johnny Curran there at full back, and I said it there in the commentary. Do you know, he deserved it for all, you know, he's done for Drummond down through the years. Poor Johnny deserved one. His son there, corner forward. You have the likes of Fergal Connor playing inside corner forward. Cullum O'Connor got a terrific point from midfield. Kieran O'Sullivan, Kieran was a member of the 97 team there, you know, that won the Scully Cullen. It is great for him. And two players, Weeshie, which we mentioned, that weren't here today. One of them is in Brisbane. He's better weather in Brisbane than we have here today. Kieran O'Sullivan, former Kerry under 21, and Kerry Minor, and Dan Sheehan. It is great. It is great for the people of Drummond.
And when you look at the likes of Diarmaid O'Shea, who's involved in the Drummond Club for, I suppose, all his life, for decades and decades, it's amazing how men like him devote their life to Smart Club. And this is his All-Ireland win today. This is his Sam Maguire. This is his World Cup. This is his FAI Cup, really, isn't it?
It is. Fully deserved to Jeremiah. He's done Trojan work down through the years, and even an officer of the South Kerry Board there, and promoter of score and what have you down through the years. It is great for Jeremiah. Mike Sheehan there, treasurer, and, you know, Sean Hardcourt, the man that brought the Drummond Pearce's club into fruition, I suppose, initially. And it is players like that, and it is the likes of, you know, when you see Declan O'Sullivan above there in the stand in Croke Park, and he's surrounded by Kerry supporters, then the South Kerry supporters, but now these are his own people. It's great for them.
Well, finally, Gary, I suppose that would be remiss of us if we didn't mention St Mary's. St Mary's were going for their 25th South Kerry title today. Some of their players have up to 9 South Kerry championship medals. Great club side, and to beat them in the final, of course, was an added bonus for Drummond, yeah, because that is like beating Kerry in All-Ireland final. St Mary's will be back because they have a good structure and they have a good club, and they were tired looking today, weren't they?
Yeah, they will, of course. The Mary's will be back. You'll never have a doubt about the Mary's because they're a great club. And do you know, a lot of the Mary's players, I was even talking to Austin there during the week, you know, he said we'd be up against it. But I mean, the structure of the Mary's, true. If there's any team that's going to come back, it's going to be St Mary's, isn't it? And probably, I suppose, we should, you know, it is no harm to have a change. I mean, I'm not taking nothing from St Mary's, but, you know, it is no harm to throw the old South Kerry Championship around, give everyone a slice of the fish, as the man says. But it'll be a month of celebrations in the Unity Tavern in Drummond, anyway. There's no doubt about that.
Well, there you have it. Drummond Pearces have won their first ever South Kerry title. It might be flogging rain and the darkness might be coming down here in Waterville, but I can tell you, for the Drummond people, the sun is shining, the moon is shining, and it's gone a long, long year. Drummond Pearces, 2004 South Kerry Senior Football Champions, for the first time in their history. It's going to make a great year in Drummond.
When it's not always raining, there'll be days like this. No one complaining, there'll be days like this. Everything falls into place like the flick of a switch. Well, my mama told me there'll be days like this. When you don't need to worry, there'll be days like this. When no one's in a hurry, there'll be days like this. When you don't get betrayed by that old Judas kiss. Oh, my mama told me there'll be days like this. When you don't need an answer, there'll be days like this. When you don't need a chance, there'll be days like this. When all the parts of the start to look like they fit, then I must remember there'll be days like this. Playing tricks. When you don't have no freeloaders, I can get their kicks. Well, that's nobody's business the way that you want to live. just have to remember there'll be days like this. And no one stops dreams. There'll be days like this.
When people understand what I mean,
there'll be days like this.
When you ring out the changes of how everything is.
Well, my mama told me there'll be days like this. Oh, my mama told me there'll be days like this. Oh, my mama told me there'll be days like this. Oh, my mama told me there'll be days like this. Oh, my mama told me there'll be days like this.